If you are a beginner, an intermediate student, or an advanced student, this should help you. I'm going to teach you the simplest way to start learning Java using a scalar pendulum and some beautiful legs as well. Many have asked me so many things about Java, even though I'm a palm wine guitarist. I didn't want to go there, because that's not my area anyway. But no one can dispute the fact that Java is nice. Java is simply nice, yes. Especially when the players are good. Man, the reason why I would want to encourage someone to learn jazz is not just to play jazz, but to borrow some of their beautiful legs to do your own thing. And I'm going to give you the simplest way to start learning jazz here. The simplest way. Jazz is a language. And like any other language, you can only speak it if you learn it. You can learn thousands of scales, thousands of what legs. But hey, it's a voice thing. Learn what they play, the exact thing they play, the exact legs they play. If you play the exact legs, you'll be playing sound like them. Here is the truth. Someone can learn their legs without understanding any theory, and yet he will play it. Believe me, that is true. So any genre which you would want to learn, you can pick some of their legs and learn it straight forward. You will sound like them. One of my favorite jazz is Summertime. Why? Because it's simple. There are not too many chords. A minor 7 and E dominant 7 sharp 9. If you can learn solos on just these two chords, man, you will be playing jazz, I tell you. The fact that we have dominant 7 sharp 9, this cannot be a high life or palm wine chord. It's a jazz chord. So you will be playing jazz, right? I have given you lots of lessons here. And one of such lessons was scale arpeggios. I'm going to teach you the simplest way to use the scale arpeggios to play jazz. I don't know whether you've gone through some of my lessons on scale arpeggios, but if you haven't, let me go over and tell you what I want you to do. We have 5 major 7 shapes on the board. With respect to key, see, this is the first one. C major 7 between the 7th, between the 10th and the 5th position. Then the C major 7 between the 7th and then between the 5th and the 7th fret position. All this, sometimes you can play A minor 7 or A minor 7 for that. A minor 7 is the relative minor of a C major 7, so it works. So if you learn this, C major 7, leave the next one, or this. And then the second shape is this. This one, we have another one here. And then the last one here. Now because it's very near to the bridge, I would want to bring it here. Either here or here. I'm in standard tuning and in the key of C. So when you have the first shape, which is this one, this will be your scale. I want you to pay attention to my fingers. When it comes to scale arpeggios, whatever can be played in the major 7 can also be played in its relative minor. This is what I wanted to try. The second shape. The third one. The fifth one, that is the simplest. It's like a pentatonic scale with the soul reduced to a fa. Why should you learn this? You should learn this because the moment you play this as it is, the moment you decide to play with this note at their respective places, you will be sounding jazz ready. Yes. So just listen to this. to make sure I either end on a C major seven or on A minor seven and see how beautiful it is. Or on A minor seven and see how good it is. Arpeggios to a higher height, then you can combine them. And those who really want to play guitar horizontally, combine the notes in a beautiful way that they can use. For instance, please take the numbers rolling on the screen. Give me a call and let's do it.